Cactus.
How about if I come down and punch your head off?
Cactus.
You blowing smoke up my ass.
Cactus.
You think a tracer can stop me?
Okay, I guess I should get started. I've been playing just crap at you guys for 30 minutes now, so I'll get started. I'm sorry. Jeez. Shut up, Gloria. So today's show is sponsored by Neon. Thanks, Neon, for sponsoring the show. She does her own prank show at 976neon.com. Does she still do that, though? It seems like it's been a few weeks since she did a show. I don't know what I'm doing today. I think I'm just going to do a bunch of Tenants from Hell because I was looking in my live show notes and I just have a shitload of Tenants from Hell numbers still that somebody sent me. Apocalypse sent me. And I don't know if these are ones that didn't answer or what. If that's the case, then this is going to suck. Oh yeah, some of these have notes on them. Did not answer. But I have other lists, so if this doesn't work out, we will move on to something else. Yeah, that's what we'll do. By the way, I tried to broadcast this on Shoutcast today. And that's something I haven't done in a really long time, probably a year now. I don't think I've broadcast on Shoutcast. You know, Shoutcast, the little streaming player thing that I have on phonelosers.org up there in the sidebar. Because last time I did this YouTube show, people were complaining that, you know, the YouTube doesn't work that well for them on mobile and stuff. So I want to use Shoutcast, but apparently I've forgotten how to make it go because it won't go. Maybe my password changed or some sort of setting. It won't go, though. So sorry, everyone. No Shoutcast today. If you can't hear it on the stream on YouTube, then it just sucks to be you. You'll have to wait for the podcast version. You're not going to get to hear all of the ringing and the bad pranks that I take out of the podcast version. Sorry. Did anyone do their homework assignment from the last show? You're supposed to write poetry and read it on the voicemails. I'm going to have to look at voicemails during today's live broadcast just to see if that happened. It probably didn't. I know I didn't get any emails with recordings in them, so probably not. So let's see, let me try and find these numbers. Did anyone listen to Party Time with Laugh Track Matt and Zax yesterday? I was on that for a little while I played Legos on Twitch. Twitch.com/phonelosers, by the way. It was fun. I guess. I mean, it was alright. Not as cool as this show, of course. But I think you can listen to Laugh Track Zax at the old Prank Call Nation thing that apparently still exists. Mixlr.com, or no, probably just prankcallnation.com, I guess, is where they put the shows up. Okay, here's the first one. Oh wait, no, I think this is going to be a problem. So if anyone in the chat room on YouTube, if you're listening on YouTube and you're watching in the chat room, you can throw ideas out there. I'll do what I can.
Thank you for calling the Lindy Apartment.
So I think we're going to start out with a big list that didn't answer last time. Oh, there's only maybe three more that I have a note that they didn't answer. Oh, I can't even hear you. Hold on. What'd you say you were?
Highview Apartments.
Oh, hello. I'm a tenant here at Highview. How are you doing?
I'm fine.
That's good. I have a problem.
All right. Did you call the right Highview? Are you at the Highview that's over there by UTSA?
I'm on Rigsby.
Oh, Rigsby. Okay.
Did I get the wrong one?
No, that's the right one.
Oh, okay. That's good. Yay.
Can I get your name?
Sure. It's Roy.
Roy?
Yep.
Okay. How can I help you, Roy?
I'm stuck under the office.
I'm sorry, say it one more time.
I'm stuck under the office.
You're stuck at the office?
Under the office. I've been tunneling for quite a while now toward the office underneath. And I'm kind of stuck. I got wedged in. I didn't make the hole big enough. I thought I had enough room. But, you know, I'm not as skinny and spry as I used to be.
So where are you at?
I'm pretty sure I'm under the office. According to my cell phone's GPS, I think I'm right underneath you right now. But I can't even move my arms to reach up and, like, knock at you to see if you can hear me.
Okay.
But I can I can see the floorboards.
Okay. And so, what'd you need? Like, would you...
That's a good question. I don't know. DJ Miller just said I was stuck under the floorboards. I'm just going to try and wiggle my way backwards. I mean, there's no reason for alarm. I'm fine, okay? I'm just a little fat. And I was burying treasure. And my dog's constipated. And El Chapo and Sean Penn are having gay office sex.
All right. Well, I'll walk outside.
You're going to walk outside for what?
You say you're under the office, right?
Yeah, well... is there any way... Do you have a shovel there?
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
Do you have a shovel?
I would have to see.
Yeah, can you get one from maintenance?
All right.
Okay, so like outside the office, there's a gas meter where the gas pipes come in.
Mm-hmm.
Could you just start digging straight down right around there? And I think that'll open up this hole for me and I can get out.
Okay.
If you could do that, that'd be great.
All right.
Are you going to do it?
I'll see.
What do you mean you'll see?
Let me talk with the maintenance guy.
Okay. Are you going to get him to do the shoveling? Because that's below you?
Yeah.
Yeah. You're too important to be shoveling things?
Nah, that's not true.
What?
But I can do it done for you.
Okay.
All right. Bye.
Thanks. Okay, well, that was just a practice one, okay? I know that was stupid. I was just reading the chat room. I blame DJ Miller for that. I wasn't expecting an answer on these because they didn't answer last time. So that's my excuse. This next one's going to be for real. Oh, yeah. Thanks, Adam. I'm supposed to be doing a Facebook mob, aren't I? Let's see. I should have a small list here in my show notes of Facebook places we can do. Looks like we might be doing Australia. I only have one left. This guy named... Well, here, let me look at it real quick and just make sure it's good. Ah, he gave me the mobile link. I hate when that happens. Why can't Facebook detect that you're not on mobile and not display the mobile version of the page? Wouldn't that make sense? I think that makes sense. Okay, it looks like on today's show we're going to be messing with the anti-vaccination community in Australia. Apparently, people do this in Australia too. They think vaccinations are, you know, horrible and evil and, I don't know, the government's evil, something, I don't know. This one is from a guy named Rice. I think that's how you pronounce his name. Here's another Facebook mob place, which may be hilarious. Anti-vaccine places, because you know how militant those kind of people are. That's racist. I have one. It's Australian. You can introduce a little cactus into their lives. And the page is... it's m.facebook.com, because it's a mobile page. So make sure you put m.facebook.com. No, don't really do that. / No Vaccines Australia. So you have to know how to spell vaccines, and you have to know how to spell Australia. Good luck, everyone. I'm going to post... it's got that mobile... Hold on, let me reformat the link so it's not mobile. Okay. Facebook.com/NoVaccinesAustralia. There's a link in the chat room. If you'd like to leave them reviews and crazy comments on their posts, you don't have to like their page. You can just go in there and do whatever you want and read a bunch of anti-vaccination stuff. If anyone has a suggestion for a Facebook page that you'd like to see mobbed, something that you think would be fun for the shows, you can email those to me, rbcp@phonelosers.org. And I may or may not use them.
Hello, and thank you for calling Windmill Townhomes and Duplexes.
Housing Authority Sandoval.
Hello, I'm a tenant here.
Hi.
Hi. I'm a tenant here, and I just have a kind of a problem.
Oh, yes.
There's this black goo. It's coming out of the floorboards in my room.
Okay.
And I'm pretty sure it's sentient. It's moaning, and it's making threats at me.
Did you make a work order report?
No, this just started happening last night. I mean, I noticed.
What apartment do you live in?
I noticed the floor was wet days ago, so I pulled up all the carpet. I pulled up all the carpet and I threw it in the dumpster. That was me, by the way. If you wondered why there's carpet in the dumpster, I threw all my carpet in the dumpster.
What apartment do you live in?
I'm in 103, building
103?
17. Yep.
Okay, you need to put a work order for that.
But. Okay, I think this goo is sentient. You know, it's sending messages to me. Like it's able to talk. It's coming up through the floorboards. It's like seeping up through the floorboards. Did you ever see the movie The Blob?
No.
Or like that one movie, the Stephen King one, where the kids are stuck on the dock and that black stuff's coming up and killing them.
No.
All right. Well. I don't know. There's no frame of reference for you then. You're just... So there's this goo coming up through the floorboards.
Okay. All I can advise you is to do a work order report and the maintenance will go and check it out, okay?
Did you ever see Spider-Man 3 where the goo, like, came down from space and landed on his moped? Ma'am? Did she hang up? All right. Let's try again. I think that idea was from Adam. I think. Thanks, Adam. Or was it Kyle? I don't know.
Housing Authority, may I help you?
Hi, is this the person I just talked to about the goo in my room?
No, this is another manager. How can I help you, sir?
Oh, she just completely hung up on me. I was trying to tell her about this problem I was having. I pulled up all my carpet in my bedroom.
Okay.
I'm a tenant here, by the way.
Okay, what apartment do you live in, sir?
103. What happened to the other lady? Why'd she just hang up? Did she just hang up and run out or something?
You know what? I don't know. There's two lines to the office.
Oh, okay.
I do apologize
so
that, for that.
I mean, two whole lines. You could never keep track of all that, right?
Excuse me?
Well, anyway, there's this goo coming up from my floorboards ever since I took the carpet out. I took the carpet out because it was wet because of the goo.
Okay.
And there's this black goo coming up through the floorboards.
And you live in apartment 103 at 5353 Ridge, sir?
Yep, that's it. That's me.
And can I have your name, please?
Roy.
Roy.
But anyway, there's this black goo coming up, and I think it's sentient, and it's screaming at me. It was, like, screaming all night. And I'm not sure if it has, like, an actual voice box or if it's just, like telepathically screaming at me. It's hard to tell because I've never experienced telepathy before.
Okay, what we can do, we can go ahead and do, we can generate a work order for that, sir. However, we can also go do a home visit, an inspection. Mm-hmm. So we can go ahead and take pictures of the goo that's coming out of the baseboards.
Okay, well, you're going to want to keep your distance because it's kind of angry. I think I threw part of it away when I pulled the carpets out and threw it in the dumpster.
Okay.
So I think it's angry at me. I don't know if it's going to be angry at the maintenance people.
The goo's going to be angry at the neighbors?
No, like at maintenance maybe? I mean, I don't know. I don't know this goo's motivation. All he's doing is screaming at me. He's not really trying to have a conversation or reason with me or anything. But all I know is...
You know what? I think the best thing for us to do as management is for us to go ahead and schedule an inspection. Would you be available today, this afternoon, about maybe 1:30?
Inspection? I didn't do anything wrong, though. I just pulled up all my carpet. But that's because of the goo.
You tore up all your carpet?
Yeah, I pulled up all the carpet out of the bedroom.
Okay. So the goo's coming out of the whole unit or just the bedroom?
Just in the bedroom on most of the floor. Did you ever see that movie Flubber?
The movie, which one, sir?
Flubber.
The Blob?
Flubber.
No, I haven't.
Okay, all right. It was wacky. Yeah, so, yeah, the goo is, it's slowly coming up through the cracks in the floors. Yeah, through the floorboards.
Okay. Would you be available today, like, about at 1:30?
Well, I don't think I should have to do an inspection because I didn't do anything wrong. I just pulled all my carpet up.
No, no, sir, of course you didn't do anything wrong, but we would have to go out there and do an inspection so we can see what you're talking about. And, of course, take pictures. That way I can go ahead and forward them to our maintenance once I go ahead and generate a work order.
Well, is there any way I can just get it to stop screaming at me?
No, sir, I'm not screaming at you. I'm just...
No, the goo is screaming at me.
Oh, the goo is screaming at you.
Yeah, and there's so much of it's come up through the floorboards that it's completely engulfed my Chia Pet.
Okay. Are you at home right now?
Yeah, but the door's locked, and I changed the locks. There's a combination on it now.
Okay.
So I'd have to tell you the combination
okay, sir,
to open my door.
Well, we can go ahead and we're going to be out checking some of our units at this time. So we can go ahead and go and do an inspection if you like.
Well, I don't think I deserve an inspection because I didn't do anything wrong.
Okay. And you said your name is Roy?
Yes. Apartment 103. Zurbel.
103?
Yep. And the goo, it's been screaming okay. Racial slurs, and that's kind of offensive to me.
Yes, I understand.
Have you ever had this problem before?
And Roy, can I have your last name?
Have you had this problem before in this unit, or has it just been in other units?
No, sir. We've never had this problem before. This is the first that we have heard of this.
Okay. Have you heard about it, like, in some sort of apartment manager trade magazine, like, happening at other apartments?
No, sir. Not goo coming out of the baseboards.
Yeah. Sentient goo. Like, it's alive.
It's alive?
Yeah. I've been saying that the whole time. You didn't catch that?
Yeah. And I think in the best interest, I think that we should go ahead and go out there and take pictures.
It was screaming at me the whole time. It's been screaming at me all night because it's pissed.
Okay. What's your last name, Roy?
Zurbel. And I don't think a camera will work on it. Because, you know, this is some sort of otherworldly
thing.
Is there a callback number
that we can call you?
It probably can't
so
be.
So I can go ahead and speak to my
photographed.
Immediate supervisor?
Yeah, just look on your caller ID.
In my caller ID?
Yeah. It's right there. See it? Just call that number. You'll reach me.
Okay, so then let me go ahead and speak to my immediate supervisor, and then we will get back to you.
Okay, and what happened to that other lady I was talking to? Like, where'd she go?
The other lady was attending to other people at the window, sir.
Well, she was attending to me, and she just slammed down the phone.
She slammed down the phone?
Yeah, she slammed it. I heard her.
I think it was probably an error, sir.
It was like...
I do apologize for that.
Okay. Should okay. Slap her in
and
the face.
And I'll go ahead and jot your number, Mr. Roy, and then let me talk to my supervisor. And
Can I just talk to the supervisor?
With you?
Can I just talk to the supervisor, please?
She's not here on site.
Oh, just
I would actually send her an email letting her know that we're having an issue with the slime, the stuff that's coming out.
Goo.
And then let's see how she wants to go ahead and take care of that.
Tell her it's sentient goo. Sentient goo, and it's speaking in tongues.
It's speaking in tongues. Okay, sir. Let me go ahead and let her know, and then we'll get back with you.
But I don't know if you'd actually call it tongues, because I think it's speaking telepathically. So would that technically be tongues?
I don't know.
All right.
Okay, but I do apologize for the inconvenience.
Yeah.
But we'll get back with you shortly.
It's so annoying. All right. Well, thank you very much for not slamming down the phone on me like that last lady.
Okay, Roy. Thank you so much. Have a beautiful day.
You too. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah, real beautiful with this fucking goo all over the floor screaming at me, speaking in tongues. I don't know who had the goo idea, but thanks, whoever you were. That was bizarre.
Thank you for calling the Village of Cottonwood Springs. This is Crystal. How can I help you?
Hello. I am a tenant here on Loma Bonita Drive. And I have sort of a problem.
All right.
Yeah, so I don't know. There was kind of like a sinkhole that happened in my bedroom. You know, my furniture kind of fell into. I had to pull up all the carpet because the floors, I think they rotted out.
What is your address? I'm sorry.
It's 4740 Loma Blanca Drive.
4740.
Yep.
Loma Blanca, you said.
Yep, that's the one.
Okay, and you said there's something like the roof caved in.
No, not the roof. The floor.
The floor. Okay,
yes, the floor caved in.
In.
Yep.
Okay.
And I pulled out all the carpet, you know, like all the carpet in the bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went ahead because there's like this big there's a room underneath the house.
Okay.
There's like a whole room. There's like a whole like it's bigger than the house. So I opened it up. I pulled up more of the floorboards. I just used a hammer and started prying them all out.
Uh huh.
And I went down there, and there's a bunch of stuff down there.
Okay, let me call my maintenance, that way he can go take a look at it. Do they have permission to enter in case you're not home?
Oh, well, no, I don't want anyone in here. I just wanted to let you know that I've called some archaeologists, and they're going to be coming over. They're declaring this a protected land or whatever. So you're not allowed to come in here anymore because they said I'll have the rights to a lot of the stuff that's down here.
Okay, I still need to let them know, okay?
Okay, yeah, you can let them know. Just let them know they can't come in anymore, because this is now a protected archaeological dig site. There's like several different levels down there. There's stairs and everything.
Okay.
And
alrighty, then let me. I'm just gonna let them be aware of it. Okay.
Okay. Well, I might.
And
just,
your name again? I'm sorry.
This is Roy. I might just move down there. I might move down there permanently and stop renting from you.
Okay.
Just so
Roy,
you know.
Roy, and your last name, Roy?
Gerbel.
Okay, and a number that I can reach you at?
Caller ID. Just look at your caller ID. It's right there.
That's a good number?
Yeah, yep, that's it. I don't know my number, you know. It's not like I go around calling myself or anything.
Oh, okay. Alrighty then.
Okay. Also, when the first time, like, I went down in the hole, the rope was too short, and I had to, like, fall off of the rope, kind of, at the end, and I fell about 7 feet, I think. 7 or 8 feet, and I sprained my ankle.
Okay.
But I think I don't have to sue you guys, because I don't think this is technically your property anymore.
Okie dokie. I'm going to give you a call back as soon as I talk to someone. Okay? I'll give you a call back.
Who are you going to talk to? Can we just put them on...
The management. I have to talk to my manager.
I can just put them on three-way. Do you have her number? Their number?
I'm sorry?
Do you have the number? I'll just put them on three-way. It's fine.
No, I'm going to call them. I will give you a call back, okay?
I know, but I could call them and I'll put them on three-way and we'll just both talk to them together.
I'm going to place you on hold. Give me just a second.
Or if you give me the number, you know, I could just call myself without you. Are you still there, ma'am? For some reason, I don't know why, but when I go down there, this music's playing all the time. I don't know where it's coming from. There doesn't appear to be speakers. Just plays this music all the time. I don't get it. Hello? I'm in the hole now. Uh-oh. It's ringing back. And she hung up on me. I think I should save that one and maybe call it in 5 minutes. Yeah, that's what we'll do. I hope if I ever find a hole in my floor that this song is playing in it. For reasons unexplained. And that the black goo doesn't kill me.
Brooklyn Formplex, Connie.
Hi, I'm a tenant here.
Hello?
Hi, can you hear me okay?
I can't hear you. Hello?
Can you hear me okay? I'm on my cell phone, but I'm a tenant here.
Uh-huh.
And I'm underneath the apartment now. I found a doorway underneath the apartment under Building 13.
Under Building 13, you found what now?
I pulled up all the carpet in my apartment.
Uh-huh.
I pulled up all of the carpet, and I threw it in the dumpster.
And why did you do that?
I just prefer hardwood floors. I was kind of disappointed that you didn't have hardwood floors after I did all that. But anyway, I found a door underneath the floor. Like a door, and it goes...
A door?
Yeah, it's a hatch. And it goes underneath the apartment, and that's where I'm at right now. That's why it's hard to hear me, because I'm...
What apartment number are you in?
1304.
1304. I'm going to send an email over right now.
No, you can't. No, I'm underneath the apartment now, and I have the door locked and barricaded. So you can't come in right now?
Why can't they come in right now?
Because I'm underneath. I'm three stories underneath the apartment. This goes down really, really, really far. Like, it's like five levels. And it's huge.
No way.
Yeah, no.
No way.
It really does.
Where was this hatch at?
It was kind of in the hallway. I had to pull up the top layer of boards to see the hatch. I pulled up, it was like the subfloor, and it was under there. There was a hatch underneath that part.
Okay, now why can't ML come over?
Why can't who?
Huh?
What was that? You're breaking up.
I need to send ML over.
ML? No, not right now, because the door's locked and I've changed the locks.
Okay, well, you need to come up out of there and unlock the door.
Well, no, I'm busy. I'm looking through all of the documents that are down here. And
well, I need ML over there right now, so unlock the door.
Okay,
the door.
No, because, look, I have ownership. I own all this stuff because this is in my apartment, so I get to keep all this stuff. So I don't want you guys coming over and taking it from me.
You don't own anything. All you own is the top layer of the apartment. What kind of stuff's down there?
No, because there's nothing in the lease agreement about me being able to keep the stuff that I find underneath the apartment. There's a bunch of old, ancient stuff down here.
Oh, there's not.
There is. I'm pretty sure this is going to be considered an archaeological dig site.
Well, you weren't even supposed to be tearing up my carpet without my permission.
Well, I did. And if you want to charge me extra for the deposit for that, that's fine, because I can pay for it now with all the stuff I found.
Well, right now you need to unlock the door. I'm sending them all over.
Well, no, I can't. I'm downstairs right now. I'm in the sub basement. I'm on sub level four.
Well, I'm sorry, you're going to have to come and unlock the door. So come up and unlock
the
door.
No, I'm not going to do it. I'm going
to
be busy down here
to the apartment.
Cataloging.
I need to see what kind of damage you've done to my apartment.
Oh, it doesn't even matter, because I can pay for it now.
Well, whatever. I don't care. I just want that door unlocked. He's coming over now.
There's untold riches. All of this stuff belongs in a museum.
Well, I don't care about that.
I'm going to be the one to sell it to the museum, not you. Because it sounds like you're just trying to come over and...
It's not your property.
But
if it belongs to anybody, it belongs to the burden of the ground. You don't have any rights to the ground.
It's not the ground. It's underneath the ground. So it doesn't belong to you guys.
That's right. There's mineral rights. It's called mineral rights. You don't have no rights to the mineral
rights. Yeah, right. You couldn't dig down like...
Anyhow, I'm sending him all over.
He can't, because I changed the locks. He can't get in, because I changed the locks.
You're not allowed to change locks.
Well, I did that, too. So, charge it to my deposit, and she's gone. She completely believed it, too.
Hello, this is Connie at Brookwood Fourplex. I hope you're having a
She's running over to the apartment right now to steal my shit. I really want to talk to Connie again. This sucks.
Hello.
Hey, Connie. I just wanted to let you know, are you sending someone over? Hello?
Yes, I'm sending someone over.
Okay, well, you can't come over because the door's locked and barricaded.
Well, I'm coming over. It's my property, and we're finding out
how much damage you've done to my property. You don't own this property.
I want to see how much damage you've done to my property.
Well, it doesn't matter because I'm going to be down here for a long time, and I'm calling some archaeologists, and they're coming over, and they're going to declare this.
I'm coming in to see how much damage you've done to that property.
Well, that's fine, but you're going to be banned from here soon because they're going to consider this an archaeological dig site, and you're not going to be allowed to touch it because it's going to be protected land.
I don't have no problem with that.
And you're going to have to probably kick everyone out because they can't live here if it's a dig site.
Whatever.
That's a smoker's cough you got there, isn't it?
Nope, I don't smoke. I've got the flu.
Oh, I see. Okay, I'm sorry for making that assumption.
All right, well, whatever. So, he's on his way over.
Well, he can't come over. I'm not even up there. It takes a while to get up the steps because they're really big steps. When I say 5 floors, it's more like 15 because the floors are so huge. The ceilings are like, 15 feet tall and stuff.
I don't even see how that's possible because I got sewer lines and water lines and everything else running underneath that building. So I don't even understand. What are you on?
I'm not on anything. That's offensive.
Someone that would say that as much as underneath those buildings.
Well,
they gotta be on something.
I would not lie about this. There's all these documents down here.
Why are you calling? Why are you calling from an El Paso number?
Because it's my cell phone. Stupid.
No, it's not. I've done pulled the file. I had him out pull the file. That's not your cell phone number.
It is too my cell phone number.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
That's not your cell phone number.
I found a script down here for Chairman of the Board starring Carrot Top. It was just lying here in the middle of the floor.
You found what?
A script. A movie script for Chairman of the Board by Carrot Top.
Oh, good. I don't care. I mean, it doesn't bother me. I don't care what you found.
I'm just saying, well, okay, if you don't care, then why are you trying to come over here and steal everything?
See how much damage, I don't care what you found, I won't see how much damage you've done to my apartment.
Well, before you were saying that the apartment owns everything underneath the apartment, that's bullshit.
That's just law. That's just law. Mineral rights, all that belong to whoever owns the mineral rights.
That's not law. You don't know anything about law.
Well, I do too about mineral rights. I sure do.
No, that's FAA jurisdiction.
No, I don't think so.
Oh, yeah, I do. My cousin's a lawyer, so I know law really well.
Really? Well, I'm paralegal, so...
Oh, that's bullshit. You're not a paralegal,
no,
or you wouldn't work at the apartment.
I'm 4 years of paralegal. Oh. I got 4 years of paralegal, sweetheart.
Oh, yeah, did you get that 4 years of paralegal so you could work in an apartment building?
No, makes so much sense. Partnership in an apartment, dummy. I don't work. I have partnership.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah, right.
But I don't think that's none of your business.
Because a second ago you said you owned the apartment all by yourself, so now the story changes. You keep changing your stories.
Don't aggravate me no more. Kamel's on his way over.
Are you a hematologist also?
No, he's a brain surgeon, and you need one.
I'm a brain surgeon, or you're a brain surgeon?
You need a brain surgeon.
Oh, okay. Because that's how brain surgery works, right? They do an operation on your brain and it makes you smarter.
Well, yeah, maybe they can fix yours. There's no place underneath my building, I'm telling you.
There is too.
I think plumbing, and you're in trouble for tearing up the carpet. That's all I've got to say to you. I have no more time to be wasted on such nonsense.
Well, you're not allowed to come in here. I've changed the locks.
I'm allowed to bring the police in there and find out what's going on.
Not if I barricade the door. I'm going to barricade the door. I'm going to put
barricade the door, but I guess those cops about to get down.
I'm going to put all my dressers in front of the door. Police will never get in here.
You just go right ahead.
I'm going to take the floorboards that I pulled up out of the floor, and I'm going to nail them across the windows and stuff.
How would you be able to nail floorboards? What do you mean? It's all concrete.
No, you're not. There is floorboards in this apartment.
No, there's not. It's all concrete.
There is too. You don't know anything. What are you, a construction worker now? You know the difference between concrete and floorboards?
I've done it all. At my age, I've done it all. You need it all too.
You need a brain.
I've heard it all.
Yeah, whatever. You're not coming in here.
And if he has to come over with the police, he'll come with the police. Goodbye.
Yeah. Well, you're not stealing any of this gold. She hung up. I think someone in the chat room said that she needs a brain surgeon to come and operate on her throat. Yeah, right. She doesn't smoke. Like, I believe that. Hey, let's figure out what the delay is like in the chat room right now. I'm going to hit my stopwatch. Okay, I'm going to make you all type in a word. What's the word going to be? Let's see. The word is going to be hematology. Go, now. Type it. Type it in the chat room. I'm timing it. I just hit my stopwatch. 5 seconds. 7, 8, 9, 10. Jews. Balls. People are trying to guess at the word. There it goes. 16 seconds again, just like last time. That's not a horrible delay. It's worse than Mixler, but whatever. I don't care. I can live with 16 seconds. It's better than what Shoutcast used to be. Shoutcast was like a minute and a half.
Throw your J's up! Throw your J's up! Throw your J's up! Everybody in the world, throw your J's up! Throw your J's up! Throw your J's up! Everybody in the world, throw your J's up! Throw your J's up!
Pray to the J's up! Throw your J's up! All my knees, all my G's, throw your J's up! And together we will raise up!
Throw your J's up! Throw your J's up!
To the heavenly stratosphere, soldier for the J's up! Shout out to the cavalry!
So during that song, I declare Deputy P. Marshall the winner of all comments in the chat room during that song, because he says he threw his J's perpendicular to the ground. And I don't know, that made me laugh for some reason. I think we need to check out facebook.com/novaccinesaustralia. See what's going on there before we get started on more things. So the first thing they posted, it says No Vaccines Australia shared Jennifer whatever's post. And it shows a picture of a Happy Meal. It's been 6 years since I bought this Happy Meal at McDonald's. It's been sitting in our office this whole time and has not rotted, molded, or decomposed. Oh yeah, big surprise. Okay, whatever. One of those things. Someone replied to it. This is a real reply. This isn't us being, you know, doing comedy. Someone's like, probably use the same chemicals as vaccines. But anyway, we don't want to read their stuff. I'm going to read our stuff that's been posted on there today. Someone named Totally Not a Scammer says, "Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce you to the newest all-natural vaccine that can't be backed by scientific research, Roy's Cactus Serum. Roy's Cactus Serum can cure all sorts of childhood maladies, including but not limited to obesity, hair loss, erectile dysfunction." Yeah, that's a childhood malady, okay. "Uncontrolled bowel movements and racism. Act now and get a copy of Frank Patterson's new book, How to Make Your Children Safe the Frank Patterson Way." There's people writing cactus. Cactus. Wow, you guys didn't post much. What the hell? Maybe they're deleting them. I don't know. On the next post, like, why did so many kids get whooping coughs despite being vaccinated? Totally Not a Scammer, who's the only one posting in there today, says, "Tired of the debate about harming your children with vaccines? Afraid to inject your child with chemicals that haven't been proven to hurt your child? Consider abortion! By aborting, you will not have to make the obvious choice of getting your child vaccinated. Try abortion today." So thanks, Totally Not a Scammer, for, posting things. That was nice of you, even though nobody else did. Or they got deleted. They probably got deleted. Maybe. I don't know. Let's call some more apartments. You guys, what should I say to apartments?
Discover the difference at Rowlett Creek. This is Brandy. How may I help you?
Hello. I'm a tenant there, and I have a question.
Okay.
Our hot water heater, I So I replaced all, I took out the water lines and I put in these big tanks full of coffee because I wanted coffee to come out of all the water, you know, out of all the sinks and stuff. And it was working great for a while, but now I think it's like clogging up the pipes or something.
Okay. What apartment are you in?
I'm in 1139.
Okay, so let's see in here. And so, like, all the pipes, you replaced them into something different?
Yeah, well, no, I just, like, you know where the water comes in? Like, the water from you guys or from mm-hmm. the city or whatever? So I disconnected that, and I capped it off, you know? Like, it's not leaking or anything, I promise. And I replaced it with these big tanks that I put in one of the bedrooms. Like, it's like a room-sized tank of coffee. And some pumps. And so now instead of water, whenever I turn on the sink or flush the toilet or anything, it's just coffee. Nothing but coffee.
Interesting. Okay, I'm trying to figure out how to word this in the work order.
Okay, yeah. Like, when I shower, I'm showering in coffee. But I have to take short showers because, you know, the tanks are only so big and I don't want to have to refill them a bunch because it gets expensive.
Okay, do me a favor. I'll tell the guys about it. Do you ever log on to the resident portal online?
No, I don't have internet.
Let me set you up with that. So then go in there and put in your own work order so you can kind of word it.
I don't even have internet. I've never used the internet.
Oh, you've never used the internet?
No. I'm old.
Wow. Oh, my gosh. Okay, so the pipes, what pipe was it that you did that to? So they can go and find it.
The main pipe coming in, it's kind of near the hot water heater.
Hot water heater.
Yeah.
Okay, and then replaced it.
Is there somebody there that I could talk to who would get more upset about this?
That would get upset about it?
Yeah, yep.
You want them to get upset about
it? Well, not necessarily. I'm just saying, you know, like, it seems like you should be upset about this.
Well, I mean, that's not my... The maintenance will probably be a little more, but...
Okay, good.
Like,
good.
I just want to...
It's my fetish.
Yeah, because... Huh?
Nothing.
You have a what?
No, I didn't. I think it was bad connection or something.
Okay. But no, I'm just trying to word it for them so they know exactly what they're looking at.
I see. Okay, all right.
You know?
Okay, all right.
So, like, I want to guide them so when they go in, they're like, okay, well, they replaced pipes. What pipes? So I want them to be able to go directly to the source.
I didn't replace the pipes. I just replaced the water that comes in. I replaced it with coffee.
Okay. I've never had a ticket like this before.
Oh.
The resident. All right. I'm making it short and sweet.
Okay.
Okay. And then they'll come and take a look at it for you, okay?
Like my penis.
Try to figure this out.
All right. Sounds great, then.
Who is this?
So are they just going to come in and clean the pipes for me? Like, use one of those wire brush cleaners inside all the pipes or something? Because I think it's just the coffee buildup, coffee ground buildup. Because I don't use coffee filters, because I'm an anti-vaccinator.
Okay, I'm going to hang up, but this is recorded, so I'm going to try to figure out. The number is 469-524.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, we'll take care of this for you. Bye.
Okay. And why does she see... Hold on. Make sure she's hung up. 469? That's not my number. That's like absolutely not. That's a number in Texas, and these are Texas apartments. But my outgoing caller ID is 91. I think she didn't know how to read the caller ID because, you know, she's a woman. Women don't know how to read caller ID boxes. Oh, somebody. Okay, Tahoe. One second. Let me. Somebody typed the number that she said into the chat room. I'm kind of curious to see what she read back to me. Let's find out.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. 4.
So it's someone's cell phone. Let's try one more time.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice.
No answer. All right, I'm going to call my own number here quickly just to make sure that my number is coming up correctly. I'm sure she just made a mistake. She read the wrong caller ID. She probably scrolled the wrong way. What a dummy. Yeah, caller ID is just what I wrote on it. It's not a 469 number. Whoa.
The wireless customer you are calling is not available.
Oh, jeez. I thought my phone got disconnected or something weird. Oh, by the way, I completely stole that idea from Stacy. You know, my ex-co-host Stacy. She always wanted to do apartment calls, and one of her ideas was saying that we replaced all of the water pipes, the incoming water, with coffee. And then she disappeared. So I'm stealing it from her. There's nothing she can do about it. So thank you, Stacy. We all miss you. But that's not stopping me from stealing your ideas. So I'm reading chat room ideas. Just give me a second. Someone pooped in my toilet and it doesn't smell like mine. Okay. Their apartment is now owned by the Chinese government. Some guy named Trimmer says the apartment is now owned by Carrot Top and needs to be joked up. That sounds awesome. I want to see Carrot Top own a business and joke it up.
We're sorry. You.
I know I said that you can post numbers in the chat room, but it's still a bad idea, and I'm definitely not going to do prank requests that are sent in the chat room. It's just not going to happen. I'm just doing apartment stuff today, you guys. Nothing but apartments. Wow, what happened to that one?
Thank you for calling Hidden Oaks. This is Carla. May I help you?
Hey, Carla. I'm a tenant here at Hidden Oaks.
Yes, sir.
And I have a question.
Uh-huh.
I was wondering if anyone from the apartment, like maintenance or something, have been in here today?
What apartment number are you in?
I'm in 1029.
1029. Let me find out, okay?
Okay.
Hold on. Thank you. Sir, were you, is there an issue in there?
Well, it's
in your
just,
apartment?
I don't know. I woke up not too long ago, and there's poop in the toilet, and it doesn't smell like mine.
Really? hang on one second.
Okay. I'd like to tell everyone the story of Roy Gerbil. He was 5 years old when he was first vaccinated. 4 days later, he was diagnosed with terminal cactitis, cactus of the nipples. That's what's on the anti-vax page from Jacob. Someone named Cy says, I injected a microcactus to fight off the Richard Cardo bacteria, and I can't say the results of the battle, but many cactus lost their lives. That's pretty sad. Now I'm depressed. Apparently, the poop in the toilet idea is Tahoe's. Thanks, Tahoe.
This is Jessica.
Hey, Jessica.
Hey, I'm sorry. What was the apartment number?
It is 1029.
1029. And you're calling for Hidden Oaks?
Yep.
And this is where you live?
Correct, yes.
Because the name doesn't match.
Oh, I just sleep on the couch. I'm like a roommate. I'm sorry.
Okay. So what's the problem? Because I know that the lady that lives in this apartment, and she lives by herself.
Okay. Well, no, she doesn't, because I sleep on the couch. But anyway, this morning I woke up and there was. I'm sorry to to be blunt here, but there was a giant poop in the toilet. And it doesn't smell like mine, okay. or hers. So whose is it?
That I wouldn't know.
Okay, well, I no one else has a key except maintenance and you guys.
And what is your name?
Why would they come here and just use our toilet like that and not even flush?
Because I actually think that you're calling to do a little prank call is what you're doing.
What? I don't do prank calls.
Yes. What is your name then?
My name is Roy.
Roy, what's your last name?
Gerbel. I think it's probably your poop, and you're just trying to cover it up.
Yes, it actually is. It is mine.
I knew it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm suing all of you. I'm putting you all on the news.
Okay, thank you.
I'm putting you on the news. Yeah, I think she figured it out, you guys. Tahoe's poop idea just isn't that great, apparently. He's all excited that I used his idea, but... what a stupid idea. I think it's time for me to pause the live show that's happening and do some voicemails. I don't know why I don't do voicemails on the live shows. I really should. And I could just delete the voicemails that suck a bunch. Just like I've deleted about 2 calls so far out of today's live show. I probably should have deleted more. Anyway, voicemails.
Hey, Brad. It's Joe Bag. I have an idea for the show. How about you do 1 show a year? And that'll be great.
Okay.
All right, bye.
1 show a year from Joe Bag. Is that his name? If I go an entire year without doing a show, you guys can thank Joe Bag. Thanks, Joe Bag.
Hey, Roy. I've got some haiku for you.
Oh, shit.
Retarded parking. I'm sorry about the ding. Don't call the police.
Awesome.
Roof people calling. Fancy tiles from New Zealand. I'm Mildred Monday. Arby, phone loser. Getting lost in the tunnels. Is the lawn dead yet? Roy, the retard boy, calling your whole neighborhood. Go away, PLA. And people might try to say that go away, PLA, is 6 syllables, but it's not, because I took the A off the word away and changed it to an apostrophe. So it's actually go away is just 2 symbols.
Oh,
it's
okay.
2 syllables. Yeah. Fuck. Yeah.
That's
okay, bye, RB.
Completely acceptable. That's fine. But it's not fine that you said Roy the retard boy instead of Roy the retarded boy. Come on, what the hell? Thank you for being the only person who did their homework this week and sent me some poetry. As far as I can tell, in the voicemail transcription things, there is no more poetry. So I guess I should just repeat the homework assignment. You have 2 weeks to do this homework assignment, so it's all right. I'm not really angry, but your homework assignment is to write some PLA or Snowplow Show poetry and read it to me on the voicemail. Or you can even send me an MP3 of your poetry to rbcp@phonelosers.org. I just want to hear some PLA poetry, so if anyone would like to do that, it doesn't matter how bad it is, because, I mean, you heard the one that we just listened to, right? Sorry, no, that was uncalled for. I shouldn't have said that. I was just kidding. But anyway, it doesn't matter. Just write poetry and read it to me, and I'll be happy. And probably the easiest way to do that would be to just call it into the voicemail at 814-422-5309.
Brad, this is Tuttle. Out of curiosity, how many weeks in a row do you want to have a subpar show? You going for a new record?
Like 100?
I'm halfway through to Pave the World show. Garbage. Sweet Onion Chicken Teriyaki. Subpar. Distraction Services. Forget about it. You want to call that a show? I mean, I couldn't even Snowplow Odyssey. Maybe that was the last halfway decent one, but yeah. Subpar, subpar, subpar.
Sorry.
The king of mediocrity used to rock and roll. Let's, you know, knuckle down, boy.
All right.
Cactus.
You can't expect every single show to be amazing, though, right? I mean, I know I kick ass and I'm amazing, but some of the shows are going to be kind of boring, like today's, for example. I mean, I've had a lot of fun on today's show, but I'm not going to say today's show was the most amazing thing I've ever done. You know, if I want to point a new listener to my show that's never heard my show before, it's not going to be today's show. It's going to be something awesome, like the Radio Shack show from last year. That was fucking awesome. But stuff like that doesn't happen every single show. You just have to be patient and suffer through the mediocrity to get to the really amazing stuff.
Hey, Brad, it's Olga.
Hey, Olga. Make me feel better, because that last guy was kind of mean to me.
So I totally have an awesome joke for you.
Oh, thank God.
And here it goes.
All right.
What do phones wait, I fucked up. Hold on. What do phone lines like to do when they're engaging in sexual activities?
I don't know. What do phone lines like to do when they're engaging in sexual activity?
They like being tied up. I totally fucked that up at first, but, you know.
It's okay.
It worked out in the end. Okay, bye.
I was going to edit out your fuck-ups, but since you talked about them after the joke, I can't, or it won't make sense. So that's all your fault. I always edit out the fuck-ups out of voicemails, usually.
Dear Brad, it's Corbin Guy.
Hey, Corbin Guy.
And always I have.
By the way, I think Corbin Guy is probably dead or something, because this voicemail is from 5 weeks ago, and I don't think we've heard anything from him in the past couple of shows, because I've been playing mostly new voicemails. I still have a bunch of old voicemails here. So even when Corbin Guy dies, we're going to have voicemails from him, like on a bunch of shows in the future. But anyway, let's
incredibly
play this.
Awesome things to say.
Of course,
like,
you do.
Like, you need to join me for a cheeseburger, hamburger, Reuben, whatever you want to eat at my
a Reuben. What the hell? I'm not a communist.
At a location that is halfway between your place and my place.
Psh, whatever. I'll drive all the way up there just to see you, Corbin Guy.
And, sign bombing. That's something that has gone kind of under the radar for a little while. And, maybe we need to make a homework assignment.
Yeah,
for
make some bombs, everyone.
Who should go out and do some sign bombing. Yay!
What is sign bombing?
I'm getting some ideas for my local
Tell us what sign bombing is. Are you talking about just changing signs around? I'm not too sure.
Such. So, hey, sign bombing. Go out, rearrange the letters, take a photo, and send it to rbcp@phonelosers.org.
Thanks.
And, yeah, let's revel in it. Come on. You want to be cool, don't you?
I know I do. So you're talking about those signs where you can change the letters around, but do you really see many of those on the ground anymore? Aside from church signs, and those are always locked up behind a key. Not to poo all over your idea or anything, but I don't know, I just don't see a lot of those types of signs anywhere. But if anyone wants to do that, you can only do that after you do your other homework assignment, which is to write poetry for me. Then you can do Corbin's sign bombing homework. Or should I say assignment? You know those billboards that you see everywhere now? The ones that are digital, you know, giant television screens? Apparently those are really easy to hack, and you'll notice at the bottom of every single one of them, like down at, you know, eye level, down there on the bottom of the pole of the billboard, is a little box that's probably locked up, but probably not that hard to open if you try hard enough. I hear you have to create a BMP file, like of certain specifications, and you just insert your SD card. Not that I've done this, but this is what I hear from watching DEFCON talks on YouTube.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hello.
Hope you're having a good day.
Best day ever.
The sun is shining.
You might say it's a perfect day.
The birds are chirping. The old men are throwing breadcrumbs to the pigeons in the park.
I don't go outside. Come
on. I hope everything's great for you. And just wondering how your cat is. All right, bye.
So that was all a roundabout way of figuring out how my cat's doing. My cat's okay. She's sleeping here under the desk, next to the computer, because it's warm, and I keep throwing her down when she jumps up here. I think we're done with voicemails for now, so we're going to get back to the live YouTube show. But before I go, I need to make one announcement, since I can't do this on the end of the show, since it's a live show and I'm not going to tack stuff on the end of it. While I was doing the editing just now, like 30 minutes ago, Legend started messaging me and telling me the T&I box had been down for days now. And I didn't even notice that, and it's because I had to reboot a router the other day. I thought it was having major issues. It turned out it wasn't, but I reset the whole thing, and that screwed up the port forwarding, and whatever. It doesn't matter. It was broken, and I just now fixed it. So the T&I is working once again. If you'd like to call in and hack some answering machines, or hang out on the conference room bridge thing, or call the inn, you know, talk to some weird Dutch guy, or do any of the other weird things that happen on the T&I box machine, whatever thing it's called. The phone number to call, if you'd like to call in, is 206-424-8422. And I can't remember if I announced this or not, but I did add several new answering machines to the system. And I can't remember what the total is now, but I think there is a total of 9 answering machines that you can try and hack. And 2 of them are mechanical machines, you know, with cassette tapes. I move those out onto the porch so that the rewinding and clicking and all that stuff would stop waking me up. But yeah, 9 machines now, or maybe it's 8, I don't remember. There used to be just 5. I would suggest that everyone calls in to it, 206-424-8422. All right, that's it. Here's the live show again.
Gainesville Garden, this Kitty.
Hey, Kitty.
Yeah.
Yeah, hey. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
I'm not cutting out, am I?
Just a little bit, but I can hear you.
Oh, that's good. I thought I was getting DDoSed earlier. So I'm a tenant here.
I'm sorry, what?
It sounds like you're in a restaurant or something. Where are you at?
I'm in the activity room.
Oh, okay. Can you tell everyone in there to shut up?
No, I can't.
All right. Well, I just have a question. Can you hear me? I'm a tenant here at Gainesville Gardens.
You're a what?
I'm a tenant. I live here.
Okay, who is this?
This is Roy. I'm in apartment 17.
Apartment 7?
17.
17? Yeah. Are you looking for Camilla?
I don't know. I just have a question. I have a problem.
Well, apartment 17 has got a woman by the name of Camilla in it, not Roy.
Oh, no, no. Camilla's my roommate.
No, she is not.
She is too. How would you know?
I know my tenants.
Okay, but maybe she didn't tell you about me because I'm not supposed to be sleeping on the couch. I think she hung up. Well, thanks for giving me the name of the person that lives in apartment 17.
Listen, I don't know what kind of prank you're trying to pull, but quit calling.
Well, no.
You don't live in 17.
Okay.
Do not call me. No,
I have
more,
a question.
Or I am calling the police.
I have a question.
Period.
A question. Just a quick question. God, I didn't even do anything. I never got a chance to say anything to her. I was going to ask her who lived in apartment 18.
Thank you for calling Vinajet Laguna. This is Chelsea. I'm happy to assist you.
Hey, Chelsea. I'm a tenant here, and I have a question.
I'm sorry, I missed the first part of your question.
Oh, I'm a tenant here, and I have a question. Am I cutting out or something?
It's an echo, yeah.
An echo? Very weird.
What can I help you with?
Well, I just, like, for this past Christmas, I installed a fireplace and a chimney in the living room.
I'm sorry, you're breaking up a little bit. Could you repeat that?
A chimney. I installed a chimney in the living room.
Okay.
A chimney and a fireplace for Christmas, you know, so we'd have a place to hang our stockings.
What apartment are you in?
I'm in 164.
Okay, so you installed a working chimney?
Yeah, a chimney and a fireplace. Like, the whole thing. It looks amazing. It's all brick and sandstone and stuff. It's really cool.
Okay, so what can I help you with?
Well, the problem I have is, so when I light a fire in it, the chimney doesn't go out on the roof. Because we're on the first floor, and I didn't know how to get the chimney to go out on the roof. So it just fills up the apartment with smoke, and I have to open the window, and it kind of defeats the purpose.
Is this a prank call?
Oh, no, of course not.
Okay, because I don't believe you're the resident from 164, and,
Why don't you know,
if you installed a chimney and fireplace and smoke was going out, the smoke detectors would sound.
Oh, I disabled them all. Why don't you believe me, though?
Okay, what can I help you with, sir? Because I'm not sure exactly what this call is regarding.
Well, is there any way I could just please finish the chimney and make it go out on the roof?
No, there is not. Unfortunately, that's an unauthorized modification of the apartment.
Well, it looks really good, though. I mean, it's like a professional job. I used to install chimneys.
Yeah, unfortunately, I cannot authorize that, and I don't believe I'm speaking with the resident of 164. So without further ado, if there's anything I can actually assist you with, because I don't believe this is a real call.
Why don't you believe that? I mean, like, do you show that someone else
lives
there? Because
we would know, because the smoke detector and the fire alarms that are hardwired would go off if there were smoke filling up the apartment.
No, I disconnected them. I unhooked the wires.
Okay. Really, sir, I'm going to end the call now because I know I'm not speaking to the resident of 164, and I know that that is something that would not happen if you...
How do you know I'm not the resident of 164?
Because I know the resident. I can't actually speak about them because that's confidential information.
Oh, you're better than most
yeah,
managers.
I can't go any further with this because I feel like I'm getting a prank call. So I'm going to go ahead and end the call now. Thank you.
I just
have
sleep on their
day.
Couch is all. I'm a roommate. Okay, let's see. I'm tired of apartment calls, and I think I want to quit, especially since I'm having audio issues. But before I quit, I'm going to do something else. We're going to do something else. Just have to give me a second. I'm going to call some more people in Texas. They're probably not going to answer, but it's worth a try. I have all these leftover lists in my show notes. And what was this? Oh yeah, these people signed up on some sort of a sheet. These are Snap Fitness customers. I called them a few shows ago, and none of them have answered. But it's worth a try, right?
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voicemail.
What am I going to say to Snap Fitness people? I actually have another list of gym numbers after I do this one. They need to stop wearing leather shorts. Okay.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice message.
It doesn't matter anyway, because none of these are going to pick up. I need to do a nighttime show and call these people. I bet you they'll answer at nighttime. This is all Neon's fault. Thanks, Neon, sponsor of today's show. Making the phones not answer.
Please leave your message for...
It's probably Neon doing the DDoSing on me.
Hello?
Hi, Renee?
Yes?
This is Steve from the gym, from Planet Fitness.
Okay.
And we have kind of a problem.
Okay.
You are aware that this is not an open carry state. You're not allowed to bring a gun to the gym. Like, even if it were, you're not allowed to bring a gun to the gym. It's against our policy.
What?
So we're gonna need you to stop doing bringing guns to the gym, bringing your gun to the gym.
Okay.
Because it's not allowed here. It's against our policy, and you're frightening the other members and stuff. We keep getting complaints.
Okay. Too bad this is a joke phone call.
This is not a joke phone call. What are you talking about?
Okay. What can I help you with? Because this is not the gym.
I didn't say you were the gym. I said I'm the gym. I'm calling from the gym.
Okay.
And we need you to stop bringing your gun to the gym.
Okay. No problem.
Okay, motherfucker. You better cut it out. How can you even work out with that AK-47 strapped to your back?
This is so weird.
What? I'm not weird. Did you just call me weird?
Okay, so who are you and where are you calling from? Because this is not the gym.
I am too from the gym.
And you are not Steve from the gym either.
How do you know what my name is?
Okay, well, I'll be reporting the phone call. Take care.
Okay, well, you should call the number back, and I'll answer, because I'm at the gym.
Okay. I've already actually had this phone call several times before and talked to the actual number that the person belongs to.
What?
And this is a scam. Thank you.
How is it a scam? What kind of scam is this?
Okay, what number are you calling from, then?
What am I trying to scam? What kind of scam would this be?
So, actually, what's the phone number, then?
What phone number?
What's the phone number you're calling from?
Look on your caller ID, dummy. It's right there.
Oh, okay. So I obviously it's a scam. Have fun. Have a nice day.
Thanks. You too, honey baby. Sweet tits. I don't remember calling. I mean, I don't know. Usually when I call a number, I mark it off my list. I delete it. So what the hell? How did she get this call before? Maybe these are numbers that I gave to another prank call show. I have no idea. That's probably what this is. She's probably gotten like 5 calls from Dwight already. Damn it. Yeah, I should just delete this list. This list is stupid. But I've been doing this for 2.5 hours now. I think I am ready to quit. So I'm quitting, everyone. Damn you people posting numbers in the chat. Cut it out. I'm not going to call anything that you post in the chat. I know better. I've fallen for that before. I've called cops and FBI. I'm onto your scam. I know you guys are just scamming me. Bunch of scammers. So today's show was brought to you by Neon. Thanks, Neon. Everyone should listen to Neon's show at 976neon.com. I think she still does her show sometimes. Oh yeah, before I quit, I should check out the anti-vaccination page at facebook.com/novaccinesaustralia. Is there anything new? God, you guys suck today. You didn't post anything. Hate all of you. So thanks, totally not a scammer, the one person who posted things on the anti-vaccination page. What else? I don't know. Yeah, thanks, Neon, for listening. I mean, for sponsoring the show. And thanks, all of you guys, for listening. And, I don't know, visit the website, phonelosers.org, and support the show, patreon.com/phonelosers, and phonelosers.org/cactus. And go to twitch.com/phonelosers, and, you know, Legos and stuff. Okay, bye, everyone. Thanks for listening. I'm going to play a song now.